Furious team owners planning coup against NFL commissioner after seeing what he secretly did to them. Just when National Football League commissioner Roger Goodell thought things couldn't get any worse for his crumbling career, the disgruntled team owners are finding a way to make sure that he pays for his actions. As all of America knows, the NFL has taken a turn for the worse. The formerly booming business that is professional football turned into a platform for out-of-control social justice warriors to make their causes known. That trend turned many patriotic Americans off the sport in a big way. The league has lost hundreds of millions of dollars, and stand to lose much more. The loss in advertiser dollars is a result of the downturn in TV viewership because of the national anthem protest. The loss of so many fans has made it difficult for the networks to even justify continuing with all the games they had planned to broadcast. The obvious answer to the problem that the league has been having is to just ban the offending activity. The NFL has a long history of making rules about anything and everything to improve the game experience. However, despite repeated requests and even pressure being put on the commissioner by team owners, he refuses to take the politically incorrect stance that would end the money problems for the NFL. According to Bleacher Report, that has caused Jerry Jones, the owner of the Dallas Cowboys, to hit back in a big way. The contract extension for Goodell should have been confirmed sometime in September of this year, however the protest, and Goodell's lack of willingness to put an end to it, caused Jones to block the contract's progress. Jerry Jones and 16 other NFL owners reportedly spoke on a conference call in an effort to find out whether they could hijack a contract extension for NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell, according to Chris Mortensen and Adam Schefter of ESPN. "You don't get to have this many messes over the years like Roger has had and survive it," one owner said Thursday. Added another owner, maybe Arthur Blank, the head of the compensation committee, "and that committee think they're on track. But they have a lot more resistance than they counted on, and maybe they don't know how the resistance is growing as we speak." While most of us didn't pay much attention to Goodell before the national anthem protest, apparently this debacle is just the latest example in a long line of inept decision-making on the commissioner's part. Goodell might be under the same misconception that the players are under, that they're somehow irreplaceable. The team owners who are seeing huge losses are about to straighten that confusion out. Goodell's tenure has certainly been controversial, from the league's handling of issues like CT and domestic violence among its players to questions about the commissioner's broad authority over discipline and the latest debate about player protests against police brutality and racial discrimination during the national anthem. As Mortensen and Schefter wrote, "There is an unrest among a certain group of owners that were on this week's conference call that are unhappy with a wide range of issues ranging from Goodell's performance to certain NFL employees to the league's Los Angeles situation and to other issues that date back to the Ray Rice situation and beyond." The reporters added that an extension for Goodell was expected to be done in September, but Jones has continued to obstruct those efforts. While Jones would need to assemble a group of 24 owners to oust Goodell as commissioner, it's clear that there is unrest. To be clear, no one is saying that Goodell or even the owners should require any players to change their beliefs. The personal feelings of the players are their own, but they are just that, personal. It is of course not a requirement that a player agree with an owner's political beliefs to play for his team, and it never has been. What the owners are looking for is some guidance and boundaries that would allow the game to resume its former bipartisan appeal. "That was our recurring theme, that there's no leadership," one executive told Mortensen and Schefter. "Everyone there, in the league office, is trying to win the latest news cycle, and there's no long-term vision. It's just, how can we minimize the bad headlines, maximize the revenue and move on to the next day? And there's an increasing frustration to that approach." The team owners and the former fans of the league aren't looking for damage control at this, they're looking for someone to make sure the problem goes away, for good. If Goodell can't or won't do that, the team owners have made it clear that they'll find someone who will. Both Goodell and the anthem protesting players have made it clear that they care more about their cause than they do about the game of football or American patriotism. If the team owners get their way, the whole group might be looking for a job soon, and not a moment too soon.